put you on the track.
And we're bringing you the latest.
Here we go.
Welcome back, kids. I'm Ayianna Lawrence.
And I'm Steve Colin.
And we are bringing you the latest. Here we go.
Here we go.
Hope you kids enjoyed your weekend.
Last varsity football team had a blowout against Bridge Prep Academy.
Let's see how they did.
On the breeze, let's go! That's why. You saw where you was at the ball.
As you can see, the Grove has came through with a Category 5 hurricane once again. You know, it's looking real bad. So, I mean, as we get this two-point conversion after a turnover by Chris Petit, senior, number 13, we're just going to go back on kickoff and do it again. Grove out.
Also, this year, our cheer is bigger than ever.
With a full JV and varsity team.
They have been working all summer in preparation for the school year.
Let's take a look at what our cheerleaders have been up to.
One more time. It's the timing. The majority had the left leg up front. When you cross, and it is where? Here, not behind you.
Hey guys, I'm Coach Jones, head cheer coach for Inlet Grove Community High School. This is my second year coaching.
Hi, my name's Ariel. This is my second year on the squad.
Hello, my name is Denisha, and I'm the co-captain on varsity.
The best part about coaching for me is seeing where the cheerleaders started and where they end up, like by the end of the season, like you're seeing the growth and progress.
Things I look forward to during this cheer season is learning new stunts, because we only have 3 stunts right now. I feel like we could have way more. And basketball season, because everybody loves basketball season.
What I look forward to during the season is probably senior night. What I like most about being co-captain is leadership and getting to practice leadership before I step out into the world.
What you need help on?
Okay, so 1, 2, 3.
Something I am really looking forward to is senior night / alumni night, when the new squad actually gets to reunite with the girls from last year, the now college freshmen, and cheer together at halftime.
Some things we could really work on, I would say, not lollygagging in practice, because I do laugh a lot in practice, but I feel like it can go way better if we like actually paid attention better.
One thing that the cheer squad needs to work on is probably voice projection.
I think the biggest improvement overall is just being in sync and projecting their voices.
Basically. T-O-U-C-H, we want a touch.
So
let me see you do it. No. T-O-U-C-H.
Like I'm gonna pass somebody.
You're like rolling it in.
Okay, so
T-O-U-C-H, we want a touch.
Dr. Johnson has also had an educational experience for the students to show off what skills they've acquired.
Let's see what the students have to show off.
so special.
Scott was not at fault. If Scott, my client, would have known TJ had a gun, he would not have left the house that night when everything went down in his own home.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, all the evidence is right in front of you. And it's Carl's and Tanya's fault for letting a real gun in the house in the first place.
The defense has been trying to convince you of a lie that Tanya Brewster is innocent, which we know is not true. One thing remains to be the same. Tanya Brewster was negligent in her role of being a mother. She allowed a man she barely knew, essentially, to enter her home.
Jury, your job is so crucial in today's case because of a young man's future aligned with the decision that you make today. Thank you.
Now for our trivia questions. This week's questions are about politics.
Let's see how well our Canes know about their American government.
In that Barack?
Oh my God. Hold on, we said that.
Hey guys, it's Basley, and today we're gonna be asking trivia questions.
What number president is Joe Biden?
The number? Oh, dang.
What number is Joe Biden? Ain't he like 30 seconds?
30 seconds?
Yeah.
I don't even know.
Isn't he like 46?
I don't know.
To be 46? Honest, I forget that he's our president.
What American?
46.
Okay. Where is Alaska located?
Alaska?
I think that's outside of the U.S. Yeah.
It's in the United States. Alaska, my fault. Hold on, restart that.
Yeah, hold on. It's above, next to Canada.
What is Obama's last name?
Isn't that Barack?
Obama. What did Christopher Columbus discover?
He discovered America, right?
Anything. He didn't discover anything.
Technically, he discovered America.
He didn't discover anything. What?
Nothing. That's a scam. The United States. Well, basically, he was in Florida, but you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
United. USA.
What TV show was Dr. Binks on?
Dr. Who?
Dr. Binks.
Who's that?
TVS Kids.
Grovewatch TV?
This is a big video. That's
power.
Thank you.
And finally, Mr. Lambaz is back at it again with another exciting project from our very own students.
Students created extravagant abstract structures alongside the parking lot. Let's see how well it went.
So the class made paper origami swans to represent birds in the sky, and we tied them to little knots and strings and made a little, just a giant area and swarm of birds, basically. The project we did on Friday was really fun because it was very interactive with the students and everybody else in the community, and we did something productive for the environment.
That was amazing. As always, the architect and pre-engineering students have done it again with their unique structures and creations.
What do you think they'll create next?
That's all for this week. Thank you for tuning in. On Grovewatch TV.